Well, it's one of the questions I posed myself in my presentation at the Poly Symposium was defining digital history. In that I don't know that it's a term that I normally use myself, although I can identify with it easily enough. But I wanted to distinguish between the research and conceptualization side of digital history and the presentation side of it. So a lot of it is just presenting your results in digital, that is to say electronic, often graphic form, but some of it is the research, and which can be, so I first called it quantitative history when I began in those days. But that was where it was, a quantitative history could be on a calculating machine, as it was when I did my first linear regression. So it's grown. It's now about a medium as well as a research technique. It works in probably different ways for historians working, especially on texts, and for those working on quantitative material. So I've come into it more as a social and economic historian and not done quite so much for on the textual side of things. But it makes you address larger quantities of data. It makes you think about transforming your data and not just taking the document as is, but looking for stretching to find ways of new, coming up with new data, new questions. And I think that it makes you think about theory in history. So then there's different theories for different parts of it, literary theory, economic theory. That's the way I came in. That was pretty straightforward. But then it goes beyond that and faces you pretty explicitly with the audience, creating an audience, conveying materials to an audience. So it makes historians think about all the things they ought to be thinking about, I think. Well, I slipped into it incrementally, you know, first doing just quantitative work as an economic historian. That goes back to the 60s and 70s. And then I got interested in social history and studied at the Newberry Library. Social history and quantitative methods at the same time. So that added, that gave me a lot of new readings, including a lot of things in American urban history, which as an Africanist, those were not my particular issues. And then after a few years, it really began helping me develop new research projects. If you make Ken Burns' videos into digital history, then it's reaching an audience that reaches at least as far as the History Channel and so forth. But I think for now it's reaching a smaller audience, with the potential. Things that we just see presented on the Encyclopedia for Chicago, a Chicago show, which you can really add to the audience for history. Just to interrupt that and go ahead a little bit, what I found in doing my teaching is that when I assign students to make and turn in digital papers, you know, they dig a little further, a little more dependably originally with the research that they're doing. So I don't think it's going to make them into historians, but I can see some additional interest that comes from looking at things that way. Now, I teach a course that I'm in the middle of right now on early African history. I have it divided into five segments, first on human evolution, then on language and archaeology and a few other things. And then the students are divided into groups, and every 3 weeks they have to submit a paper, which is based on their reading, but also on materials that they found on the web and assembled. So they have to learn how to work as groups, which you generally have to do in digital work, and they have to make nice images and good arguments. It's a lot of fun. Well, I think the field of history has a lot of very positive potential at present, because there are people in about every field of study, natural sciences included, that are defining their work in historical terms and therefore coming to a connection to history. And I think that organizing the materials in a multidisciplinary and through a bunch of visual and electronic media, that historians would be actually able to navigate all of this wonderful new information that's coming to us and, you know, in a sense, return history to that place that it had, rather than being background, but being as a field that knitted together and integrated materials from all different fields. That's probably a little bit further than history will actually get to go within our lifetime, but I do think there's movement in that direction. Oh, it's central. So Richard Jensen is the one who got the NEH grant, got settled there, but Jan Reif was faculty throughout, and so I was a student in the program and then a teacher in the program for 2 years, and got to watch the number of people who came through just in the time when I was there. So the mix of learning statistics, learning to punch things in on the computers, and on the other hand, reading and debating this wonderful library in social history that they put together has been really formative of personal relationships and of academic thought thereafter. We need somebody doing a doctoral dissertation on the historiography of those workshops starting in the 1970s and their consequences.